when you're here with us, as we're doing every Sunday right here answering your questions. I'm talking about things that truly matter in life and, of course, the afterlife. I encourage you to be bold and brave. Go to your phone if you always have a question or life situation question anywhere in the U.S. of A. Dial 800-520-1534. That's 800-520-1534. Kate, welcome to the Jesus Christ Show.
Thank you, Jesus.
You're welcome. How can I help you?
I am in a Bible study, and we have been studying the book of John, which is wonderful, and I have just loved it. But John 20:23, the explanation of the Bible study is that they did not have the ability to forgive sin, and that mere humans can forgive a better person. Yeah. I was wondering if you could speak to that, please.
Well, with them, whoever was teaching the Bible study not here to defend their theology or their thoughts, I can't speak to what they were trying to get at. But I will tell you, what's going on here is very interesting, right? Because you have Doubting Thomas and backstory intertwining here. And you have basically a discussion, if you will, about doubt. And that there are those that believe and those that don't, right? So that verse is actually, and it's me speaking, that verse says this: if you forgive the sins of any, their sins have been forgiven them. So that doesn't make sense, that interpretation that you described. Because right there it says so. And it says if you retain the sins of any, they have been retained. This whole discussion is really about believers and non-believers. And so if there were somebody that rejected the gospel, then now after the death and the resurrection, they could say you were saved or not saved. Not because they're given the power of, saying you're not saved or you're saved. It's because they're recognizing the acceptance or the rejection of the gospel. So it's not... It's really about acknowledgement rather than some magical power, like it's a magic wand being waved and saying, boom, here you're saved. Not the acknowledgement or the recognizing of those that have received and accepted the gospel or those that have rejected the gospel. There's nothing about they can't forgive. All that is under, this is talking about the Holy Spirit, this is talking about rejection, this is talking about acceptance. All those things play a big part. Carol, welcome to Jesus Christ Show.
Thank you. I was calling because earlier when you were talking about soul going to heaven first, without you creating it.
Same thing.
Same thing?
Yeah, same thing.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure because I wanted to be cremated, but you said the body comes later.
Well, here's the thing with cremation. There is nothing in the Bible that says that you can't get cremated. As a matter of fact, it's becoming more and more a popular option. Or it's ecological ramifications, financial ramifications, all kinds of things. But imagine this, that when you go to the book of Genesis and you see about the creation of humanity to begin with, it's really from the dirt and the ground, essentially. It's from very simple things. And so cremation is not going to destroy the body the way you Carol doesn't have a body. Apparently, she was too cheap. Decided to burn it. Not the way it's going to go down. The time of the resurrection of individuals, or the raising of those bodies and the saints, is really tied into God, the power of God. Not, you know, hey, did you keep it in decent shape? Did you embalm it properly? Did you do all of those things? That's not what's going to matter. What's going to matter is where your faith lies, what your beliefs are, and those things are going to establish what the next life is going to be. And God will resurrect you from any state. As a matter of fact, the common theological belief is that you won't have any wounds at all. Now, redemptive wounds, the wounds that I suffered, those still existed because they were redemptive. So, the wounds in the hands that Thomas saw, cut aside, those types of things, remained in my body because they were redemptive. But everyone else is going to be whole and complete in that sense, and therefore in the state of nature, even to the point where you are not in true ash, God can still recreate you. And I know that it seems to a human like, wow, that's, you know, how do you talk about a puzzle? And now it's ashes, and God's got to come in and have to be built from the ash. But you're dealing with God. That's not. Oh man. Okay, how's that song again? The hip bones connected to it. I am never going to get this together again. It's going to take me forever. God created you from the dust. God can rebuild you from the dust. And really, when you're dealing with the afterlife, you're dealing with a lot of really beautiful and miraculous transformation. And being reunited with your Maker and going through that process, there's so much beauty in all of that. And God is so well orchestrated in the way God has allowed you this opportunity here on earth to learn and experience and enjoy the next in life, all pointing towards, all with the goal of having that final time in heaven and being in heaven for eternity is a pretty powerful experience. And so all of the things that preceded here in life have a purpose and a goal that God set for you and glorified you. And so people kind of get caught up in the technicalities and what about this world? I've got great questions. But God's not going to let cremation. There's nothing, once spiritually you've given yourself to God like that, nothing's going to stop it like cremation. Nothing like that is going to keep God from resurrecting that body and having you be with the other saints in heaven. Jill, welcome to the Jesus Christ Show.
Hi, it's Jill.
How can I help you, Jill?
Well, I have a question, and my kids actually kind of know this question.
Uh-oh, they're the tough ones. Well, okay, there's a couple of questions going on here. First of all, and this can be difficult for a child, incest had to take place early on.
And it wasn't.
There wasn't just Cain and Abel. If you read through Genesis, you'll see that they were sisters as well. They just aren't important to the narrative in the sense that Cain and Abel deals with the first murder, a necessity at one point, and therefore it was okay. And also the genetic line was so pure at that point that it was okay. But then as the genetic line starts to get polluted, God says no more. It's not needed anymore. There's enough distance, and to bring incest into the situation would have caused more genetic problems, which is what it would do today. Or could do. So then God put a stop to it. And that happens many times throughout scriptures where something is okayed by God for a certain amount of time and it's not. So that's the first part of that. The second part of that is there are not multiple races. There is one race, the human race. That's all there is.
That's true.
But I'm not even talking about political crusades. There's only one race, human race. And there's only one color. The color in humans is called melanin. That's what makes people lighter or darker. So, and the amount of melanin in the system is what makes them darker. But everyone has melanin. There's only one color. So at different with different amounts of it cause the appearance of the different color. But there's only one color of humanity as well. So when you're starting to deal with ethnicity, really what you're dealing with is culture or ancestors. So you look around and you see this is what we have to do, this is what we have to build with, whatever it is, that is what builds those cultures. But if you look at the essence of all humanity, it's exactly the same. Building blocks are exactly the same. The color is exactly the same, it's just in different shades.
Okay, well,
is it? Okay, you are.
I know. Oh, I have a call-in coordinator. You know what, it's your job, basically, to push people...
Keep
up,
also prioritize. Let me ask you.
Right,
is it? Okay, you are.
Don't worry. Oh, with Dean Sharp, the house whisperer this morning at 9 on KFI AM 640.
What is the stimulating call? Bring the phone to the hit true crime podcast.
$6, $9908, or visit AmericanVisionWindows.com. And now,
I've never looked back. That urge you to do the same if you're worried about the way inflation's going. They have a brilliant team of experts who run through your options and help you to keep safe. And if you're quick, this month for any qualified IRA, you'll get a free Astor American Virtue coin as a thank you. You can't go wrong.
confound it up with different languages so that people didn't have to go to different areas and therefore start new cultures in their stories. And whether you believe that's the origin of it or not, essentially that kind of is what took place. People went to different areas. Certain things became more important. Certain types of foods became more important because the climate was different. Just like if you would go to Italy, food in southern Italy is different from the food in northern Italy because the weather is different quite a bit, and it's contingent upon what, you know, people are going to eat stews and soups in places that are cold, these types of things. And those shifts become, or adaptations based on the needs, but they're all within, they're within everyone, and the switches were turned on or turned off based on necessity. But genetically, there are people who are very, very welcome. Excellent question. And smart people. I like that. For them to get fired up and ask you questions like that is really, really wonderful. And remember, more important than all the ugliness in the world, these simple words. I am with you. Always.
Into a gym and Pilates studio. If Madonna gets her asking price, it would be the highest price. highest homes sold in the area so far in 2022. Amy King, KFI News. Now headed out, also headed for a crash on the 105. So we're into that problem 105 east at Nash. Multi-car crash in the two left lanes. They are trying to clear it off to the shoulder, but traffic backing up for you from Sepulveda. Normally, we're wrecking the right lane 55 north of Alondra and delays from the 91. And if you're headed through Studio City 101 north at Finland, a fender bender in the middle line has that. Your citation is now on the scene. KFI with side help. Get to there faster. I'm Shannon Kircher.
Hey, all this is Sharp. You know, when you hear me say that there are only two kinds of solar companies, Sunlux and everyone else, I am not kidding around. Neither is Tesla. Yes, the solar giant who, for the first time, has opened their entire ecosystem to only a handful of trucking companies. And guess who Tesla selected for Southern California? Exactly, Sunlux. Sunlux and Tesla. Tesla panels, Tesla low-profile mounting system, and the world's single most sought-after solar component, the Tesla Powerwall battery. Anybody can order them, but Sunlux can actually get them. It all amounts to the most advanced solar in the industry, and it's all now waiting for you at Sunlux. You know what? There really are only two kinds of solar companies in Southern California. Sunlux and everyone else. Get the whole Tesla solar ecosystem, including Powerwall batteries, at sunlux.com. That's sunlux.com. CSLV 1037.
Contractor license 10477, anyone?
Zach, is that you?
Yeah.
Do you know what time it is?
Look at your cell phones.
It's time for rejuvenation.
What?
Air conditioners work 24/7. And rejuvenation brings them back to life, all rosy cheek, and it puts a spring in their step.
What's the work? The benefit of rosy cheeks and a springy step.
Your AC will cool better, last longer, and use less energy.
You gonna clean my outside cold?
The right way, not the easy way.
It makes all six critical adjustments.
Of course, we never do anything that way.
What's this rejuve thing gonna cost me?
$129. But you're not saying it right.
How am I supposed to say it?
Rejuvenation.
If I say it wrong, you'll still come over and do it?
Sure.
GLE, GTL.
Or you better, etc.
We do things well, but it's as crazy as well.
As the country bounces back from COVID and mask mandates are lifted, your business needs a lift too. Promote your company right here, right now. Radio has connected 93% of Americans every week. That's more than Google, more than Facebook, more than TV. In fact, radio reaches 20% more millennials than TV. Want more of the people you want to talk to all in one place? Visit iHeartAdvertising.com and get AM and FM working for you. That's iHeartAdvertising.com.
As the experts in transmissions for over 50 years, there's lots of FMs that we haven't heard.
So I ain't gonna ask.
It's just a belt. And nothing we can't fix.
It's going.
What's that?
From transmissions to everything
in between. No credit.
Punching through
your
ear
income. Exclusions apply to your CRS. Yes, yes.
From the driveway.com weather center, sunny, warm, and windy in Metro LA and inland OC, highs in the 80s. Plenty of sun as it freezes well, and inland Empire highs today in the low 80s. Beach is sunny and warm, highs in the mid-tropical 70s. Right now, 64 degrees in Gardena, 68 in Rialto, 64 in Missouri, 66 degrees in Burbank. Really local, I can stay by 24-hour news around Jane Allen.
Thank you. truck, look no further than the 2014 Toyota Tundra. Engine size is just the start of options available, ranging from a 4.0-liter V6 up to a 5.7-liter V8. Equipped with a 381-horsepower 5.7-liter V8, the Tundra has a towing capacity of up to 10,500 pounds, enough for any project at home or at work. Each and every detail of the exterior expresses muscularity. This vehicle achieves a sporty stance with view from all angles.
Top features include front fog lights, front and rear reading lights, one-touch window functionality, a tachometer, a rear step bumper, an outside temperature display, and much more. Additional available features include leather upholstery, a trip computer, an automatic dimming rear view mirror, a power seat, skid plates, a trailer hitch, and more, based on your selected trim.
Toyota also prioritized safety and security by including dual front impact airbags with occupant sensing airbag, head curtain airbags, brake assist, a panic alarm, and four-wheel disc brakes with ABS. Standard safety equipment includes vehicle stability control, traction control, and smart stop technology.
The 2014 Toyota Tundra. With potent V8 power and performance equipment integrated throughout, this truck refuses to compromise.
Is its affordability. And as a general rule, here's the first pearl I'm handing out today. The more affordable a material is, the more of it you will tend to use. The more you tend to use of any one material, the more important it is to use it correctly. Right? That makes sense. Both in terms of its design and the installation quality. So, that's where we're going. Because all these projects belong to the category of resilient floors, right? Now, if you look up the word resilient, you can find the first definition in the dictionary is able to withstand or recover quickly from difficult conditions. And, you know, okay, sure, that could apply. But that's not really what we're going for. In the case of resilient flooring, it's a technical definition. It's the second definition in the dictionary. It is an object or a substance able to recoil or spring back into shape after bending or stretching or being compressed. That is the very definition of a...
Hello, what do you want to eat about lunch?
I'll cook my own food.
Okay, mommy, cook a potato for
you? No need!
Like vinyl, but from wood flour,
yes.
Yes.
Oil, pine tree resin, mineral pigments, and jute fibers. All of which have this in common. They're all natural materials. They're all decomposable, they're renewable. Linoleum is technically edible. And I'm not encouraging to please do not eat linoleum. I'm just saying, it's really amazing product. And unlike vinyl, linoleum, the color of linoleum is throughout. Not just on the surface, it's through and through. It's durable, fire-resistant, it's biodegradable, recyclable, it's good air quality, no VOCs, hypoallergenic. So there are a lot of really good reasons to like linoleum. And, surprisingly, a lot of good designers out there, or I should say not surprisingly, there's a lot of good designers out there, myself included, I would hope, on that list. Use linoleum far more than you would expect, and in places that you wouldn't expect. But when it comes to the floor these days, it is luxury vinyl plank, LVP, and luxury vinyl tile, LVT. They're the ones who are leading the marketplace by far. Everything else is a distant success. And that is what we'll be discussing today. Because they're a little trickier, a little harder to understand than what appears on the surface. So we're going to dig into it. And by the time we're done, if you're in the market for it, we're going to know.
I'm looking for my concentrate.
All right, Scott. I am so glad you joined me this morning. So much more to come to our homes. Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Listen. Kitchen store is right off the 405 in Culver City, and